Hey guys, it's Sam, and this is Top 5 Wednesday. If you are not familiar with Top 5 Wednesday, I will leave the link to the Goodreads group down below for topics and such. This week's topic is our favorite books that are outside our comfort zone. Most of us tend to stick to a few specific genres that we tend to read from that tend to be our favorites, or we're fiction readers and not non-fiction readers, so these are the books that fall outside our usual categories. For example, I tend to read fantasy, whether it's adult or young adult, and I also tend to read contemporary that is YA. So these are the books that fall outside those categories. Number 5 is Old Man's War by John Scalzi. This is the first book in the Old Man's War series, and it is an adult science fiction series. I have only read this first book, but I loved it so much. I need to get to the other books, and I always just keep forgetting about them, but this is a space opera-y type series. It takes place in a future Earth where people are enrolled in the military after they reach the age of 75, and they go fight an intergalactic war, and it's a really cool, like I said, kind of space opera-y thing, and there's a lot of things that are hinted at in this first book, and I want to get to the rest of the series, but I tend to not read sci-fi, even though I want to desperately, and I know that I talk about this all the time. So I tend to not read sci-fi, and I definitely don't read a ton of adult sci-fi, so this has been my first little dip into it, and I enjoyed it. And I plan to read more. I swear I do. Number 4 is The Raven Cycle by Maggie Stiefvater, and this does fall technically in the fantasy young adult genre, but I tend to not read anything that has any element of horror, and while this isn't technically a horror genre, it is very much a paranormal, creepy series. And typically speaking, I would definitely not touch that with a 10-foot pole, but I really do enjoy this series. Yes, it spikes my anxiety, and I have to be very careful when I read it, and I tend to read it alongside something else that's light and fluffy because I do care about these characters so much, and I get so nervous about all the things that are going on because it's a creepy series, but I really do like it, but it is very much outside of my comfort zone. Number 3 is Maybe Someday by Colleen Hoover, and this is a new adult contemporary that it seems like everybody really enjoys, but I definitely enjoyed it, and I, one, don't like a lot of Colleen Hoover stuff. I've read 2 of her other books, I believe, at this point, and wasn't really a fan of those, but I love this one. And I just tend to not like the new adult genre in general. I'm kind of dipping my toes into a couple other series that I really enjoy, but this was the first one that really made me think, like, there's a few new adult books out there that I might enjoy, but typically speaking, the tropes that pop up in new adult, not a fan. But this one broke the mold, in my opinion, and I definitely enjoy it. Number 2 is Melokai by Alan Bernert, and I've talked about this book a lot. I have a full review on it, so I won't talk about it much here, but this is an adult historical fiction that takes place in Hawaii during the last leper colony that was in Hawaii, and it's not something I would usually reach for, and my dad recommended it to me for about a year before I finally picked it up, and I think it's beautiful. It has stuck with me. It's also really good timing when I read it, and I just still have a lot of thoughts about it. This is actually the book that I thought about when making this topic. So, I do highly enjoy this book, but definitely something that I would never have picked up if I would have passed it on the shelf myself. And number 1 is Illumine by J. Kristoff and Amy Kaufman, because while this is YA, it is science fiction, which, like I said before, I don't typically reach for, even though I want to, but mostly because of the format that this is written in. When I first heard about this series, I heard that it was told in different, not normal prose, that it was told in documents and everything else. Everyone knows about this series by now. And I was so skeptical, and everyone talked about it and how amazing it was, but if I wouldn't have gotten an ARC at BEA 2015, I probably wouldn't have picked this up still because I was so skeptical. I don't tend to like these kinds of books in different, you know, text messaging or email, stuff like that, because it's very hard to really connect to the characters in that way, and I just was very skeptical, and this proved me wrong, like it has for so many other people, and I'm so excited for the rest of the series, but this book, while not completely outside comfort zone, because like I said, it is YA and it is sci-fi that I want to get into, is still in a format that I never would have picked up. So those are some of my favorite books that are outside my comfort zone. Comment down below and let me know some of your favorite books that are outside your comfort zone. So thank you all for watching, and I'll see all of you guys soon. Bye!